guys, this is NJ, your host on this channel. So today we will discuss about the Mount of Jupiter, a review and introduction on the Mount of Jupiter, what it represents. So before we will start our journey, I need to just give you guys a quick review of what Mount represents in palmistry. So, you know, mounts are these pads or these cushed portions at the bottom of the fingers. As per the medical palmistry, if you need to understand it, then, you know, like the way I always say that our hand contains more nerve fibers than any other part of the body. From the brain, our hand contains most nerve fibers. More than like 2 million nerve fibers are there in our hands. That is the only reason why it is used for fortune telling, and the sign gets manifested much before in advance. So coming back to the topic, the mounts. So the mounts, and via medical palmistry, can also be understood as that they contains the network of the nerve fibers. Their center is known as the apex of the mount. So something like this. And you know, it is very easy to diagnose this or see it in the rough and coarse skin. Otherwise, in the soft hand, you might have to use the magnifying glass to spot this apex, triridae. So, you know, the strength and weakness of these mount depend on the development of the certain sensitive areas of the brain and their condition, controlling the health and physical structure of an individual. So, let's say, in case if you'll find this mount center, the apex, mount center shifted towards the top side of the mount, let's say towards closest to the finger, so this would increase the prominence of the mount. If you find it shifted down towards the bottom of the mount, then it will decrease the prominence and the signification of the mount. And if you found it at, in the middle, it will be considered as a normal position of that mount. So, and this is the medical explanation for these mounts. And as per the spiritual and as the meta science is concerned, these mounts has been given most importance in palmistry by the physicist and by the palmist, because, you know, the thing is that these mounts have been known and seen as the presence of the superconscious, the presence of divine in our lives. So, you know, many palmists have even gone to an extent of saying that these mounts carry the reason, contain the reason of your creation. So we have understood all of that. Now coming to the point, which is Mount of Jupiter. So this Mount of Jupiter represents the qualities. So this Mount of Jupiter tells about someone's leadership ability, your pride, your self-assertion, your ambition, your goals, how spiritual you are, how humanitarian you are, how benevolent you are. And also it tells about the marriage mindedness. So because if we have to do the marriage consultation, and if we have to see whether this person would turn out to be a good marriage material or not, even for that we need to give preference to this Mount of Jupiter. And you know, this also tells about someone's love for nature, love for good food. So all these things are seen from this mount. So you can easily conclude and can take an idea that if this mount would remain to be in an afflicted state, so in those cases this person would turn out to be very egoistic, very tyrant, very dominating, and too much of indulgence in food and drinks. So this is a general overview of this mount of Jupiter. And you know, one more thing, I was telling you about, like, if this finger is, if in order to judge the good state of a mount, so apart from the condition of this mount, the center of the apex of the mount, which I have explained to you guys, the significance of the mount also increases if you find the finger high set on the palm, because that would automatically give larger area to this mount. So let's say, for example, if you will find this finger high set, so this is automatically giving larger area to this mount. So that also contributes to the goodness and added benefit and signification to the mounts. So we have discussed all of that. Now we need to understand that what will happen if you'll find this mount little bit shifted to the other side. So, you know, whenever a mount gets shifted or inclined towards other mount, so it also infuses, it traits, its significations to other mount, to its neighboring mount, also derive the qualities of the signification attached to that mount. So let's say if you'll find this, the apex of this mount, or this mount shifted towards the mount of Saturn. So these people would remain to be very serious, very hardworking, very diligent in their approach towards life. And also because, as we know, that Saturn represents all the late bloomers. It gives the result of your hard work, but only after too much of struggle. So these people might have to struggle in order to get the deserving success in their lives. So that will happen if you'll find this mount little bit shifted towards the mount of the Saturn. And one more thing which you need to understand, we always need to look at the mount in the combination. So what will happen, let's say if you'll find this mount of Jupiter and this mount of Saturn well formed. So these two mount well formed would, like the way I explained, these people would remain to be very serious, very hardworking and very focused towards any aspect of their life, because this person has the ambition and leadership quality and goals in his life. And also Saturn is also providing its seriousness, its discipline, its wisdom towards achieving his set goals. So that would remain to be the case. These people could be found in the careers like teaching and the professors in the universities and all the explorers, if you'll find these two mounts in a prominent state. Let's say if you'll find this mount of Jupiter along with mount of Sun in a good state. So this is a combination of someone who's like very extrovert, because mount of Sun, the finger of ring finger, they also represent extrovertness, your personal magnetism, and same is being represented by Jupiter. How gregarious you are, how social you are, how you exert yourself in your public life, how humanitarian you are. So these combination, the combination of mount of Jupiter and mount of Sun could just make someone very creative, very artistic, excel in any public speaking profile. So this is a combination of someone excelling in the public relation, in any artistic realm, in any writing, publishing, communication related profiles. So let's say if you will find this mount of Mercury and mount of Jupiter in a prominent state. So you know, like the way you people know that this, when we were discussing this mount of Mercury in detail, I have explained to you people that mount of Mercury also represents your scientific bent of mind, your ability to do research. So a combination of mount of Jupiter and a combination of very good mount of Mercury, these two mounts in a prominent state could just make someone very good in a very good doctor, very good nutritionist, very good physician, as this also represents, Mercury also represents your debating abilities, your communication abilities. And Jupiter, as it is a universal fact that Jupiter is the lover of justice, it's a justice loving planet. So these two mounts in a prominent state could also make someone very good judge or very good litigator. So these are the kind of professions which we can expect. Now comes the part, if you'll find the mount of Jupiter and this mount of Mars. This is the outer Mars, which represents your mental strength. This is your inner Mars, which represents your physical strength. So let's say along with prominent Jupiter, you will also find mount of Mars in a prominent state. So then this implies that specifically if we'll first take this mount, outer Mars, these two mounts in a prominent state can just assure that this person would remain to be very stable. You know, there will always remain to be a guard in his hastiness, because this could create the possibility of someone becoming too hasty and become little bit foolhardy. But the control and wisdom and discipline of Jupiter and wisdom of Jupiter would just keep him at guard. So these people would remain to be stable. These people would remain will remain a guard on their risk-taking abilities. And if you'll find the mount of Jupiter along with mount of inner Mars in a prominent state, then this implies that these people could just progress in any of the physical effort related profile. So this is an ideal combination of someone progressing in be it in the realm of military professions, army profession, athletic professions, because this person has the courage and this person has the ambition, this person has the goals. Then comes another mount, which is our mount of Venus. So let's say in case if you'll find this mount of Venus, which represents our love, our compassion, our humility, and a mount of Jupiter in a good state, then this explains, this tells that these people will have the love for others. They will genuinely care for others, because you need to understand that this represents our compassion, this represents our love. This mount of Jupiter represents, you know, care for humanity, all the humanitarian pursuits. So this combination could just make someone, very idol for the profile where, you know, healing is required, where giving compassion and care for others are required, whether it's in the political realm, whether it's in becoming a nurse, or whether it's become associating with the NGOs and charity related organizations. So this person can do very good over there. Now comes the last part. What will happen when you will find this mount of Jupiter and the mount of Luna? Mount of Luna in a prominent state. So this is an ideal combination that this person will have the capacity to do very well in arts, because this person has the imagination. This and Jupiter also represents your writing abilities, apart from your ambition and leadership and benevolence and all the good traits. So this person could also get also not only progress in the realm of arts, but also in any of the writing or any new publishing profile. So, you know, now I've given you a quick overview about what all these mounts represents, what will happen when along with Jupiter mount in a prominent state, other mounts in the combination will also be in a prominent state. And apart from that, as you people know that while judging any mount, the condition of finger is also equally important, whether the finger is bent or whether the finger is straight. So let's say if the finger will be bent or crooked, so that is going to negate the signification of that mount. But if the finger would remain to be in an unafflicted state, that would automatically increase the signification of that particular mount. Along with that, if this finger you would found to be, let's say, longer than the ring finger, so that will also increase the signification of the mount of Jupiter. And along with that, like the way I have even made a video on this, the first flange represents your mental traits, the second flange represents your practical traits, and third flange represents your physical traits. So someone with having a good prominent mount of Jupiter along with long and unafflicted without any negative sign, long top flange would just increase the intellectual qualities of that person. Let's say this mount, if you will find to be this flange, second flange you will find to be long and unafflicted with the presence of positive signs, then this person could fairly do very good, very well, very good in any of the business and any commerce or trade related profile. If the third mount, third flange, I'm so sorry why I'm saying mount, if you'll find the third flange as long, prominent, and you'll find the third flange long, so you know there remains to be the possibility that this person could indulge too much into sensual pleasures, food, drinks. So these are the kind of events, these are the kind of personality traits which we can expect just by looking at the mount of Jupiter and its associating combination and associated traits. So, you know, I have made myself very clear with this. You people have got to know what are the basic traits which are associated with this mount of Jupiter, its planet association. And one more thing before I forget to mention this, that in our ancient Vedic scriptures, this place has been given the place of our father, our ancestors. This place has been denoted as Pitrasthan. So even the state of our relation with our father and our relation with our ancestors and that state, about our relation with our forefathers, so that all is also seen from this mount of Jupiter. So I hope I made myself very clear on this. In our next video, we will discuss what will happen if we will find different signs, special signs on this mount. So for further more updates and notification on palmistry, please subscribe my channel and like my Facebook page. Thanks.